Hello everyone! Welcome or welcome back to my channel, Nemsha SIMS. I'm Emily and today I'm here with episode 9 of Journey Through Time! Woo! Before we get into it, I just wanted to say thank you to Moana123. They suggested to get a mod that actually disables fires at campfires because the amount of fires is just it's just excessive, and it really is not realistic for stone chairs to catch fire. Like, that just doesn't make sense. So I've installed this mod, and thank you also to What's It Toya, who gave me a link for extra traits to give to children. They thought it might add to the gameplay. So thank you both for your suggestions. I've downloaded both of these mods, and you will see them incorporated into this Let's Play. I also can't forget to shout out the player H because they're always commenting and just being overall so sweet. So thank you. Thank you very much. I had the kids playing over here, but it looks like they were too tired. Let's see if Zol is still doing what I wanted. No. Okay. We also had another bear on the lot, you guys, but it's all good. It's all good, man. I do have Etta painting once again, though. Talking to little Tiro, and I think she just finished too, actually. What good timing. And Dami has come in. Let's sell this to our collector. Don't know who's collecting these prehistoric paintings in prehistory. Oh, before I forget, I wanted to mention, I know in my first ever video, my intro, I included an archaeologist, Sarah Andrews. I was wondering if you would like to see a little bit more of her, maybe just in the beginning or the end of episodes now and then. I was thinking maybe every 10 episodes of the challenge we bring her in, but I know that it kind of takes away from the challenge in a way because we're not living in prehistory in that moment. So let me know your thoughts on that. And before I forget again, if you're enjoying this video so far, if you're enjoying this series, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and ding the notification bell. Yo, look at Zol. What is he even doing? Okay, did you see his eyes? They were like just all white. Oh, he's so sad. Oh my god, I'm torturing my Sims. I feel kind of bad about it. Not even gonna lie. So he just ate. We only have 2 servings of our mammoth that we have left. I'm thinking I give the next plate to Teb because Teb and Zol have to hunt once again. Gotta make sure that they are ready to go. People are asleep already. Well, not already. It's 9, almost 10 o'clock at night. I had sent everyone to bed, but Nias just woke up with a dirty diaper. And it's actually- did you not just change his diaper? It's actually his birthday today. We have about 2 hours? Whoa, till he ages up. But I might just do it a little early. Okay, let's do it. Nias, it's time to age up. Oh my god. Whoa, little flip in midair. Nias aged up into a little toddler. So we had a charmer, we had an inquisitive child, and I'm gonna go with independent for Nias. He's a little independent boy. Aww. Oh. Let's modify this boy. Aww. So let's take the hair off. And I got more eyebrows. Maybe something like that. Oh my god, he's so cute in the overalls. But I'm gonna have to take these off. I was thinking sometime down the line to do a cast video of all my Sims from the History Challenge in like modern era clothes. Just to see what they'd look like. Let's see. Maybe a goo goo overlay. Oh. Cutesy. I gave him these skin details and we'll add some. Oh, maybe we can't add the eyes. Why does this one come with hair? I don't understand. This happened last time. All right, I might have to add the eyelashes as glasses. I'm loving how Nias looks so already. Wow. I literally have tears in my eyes. What the hell? So I went through and gave him the eyelashes on every outfit type. Now let's look at some hairs. I got some new hairs too. Oh, this one I didn't realize came with a hat though. Etta has very straight hair, sorta. And Zol doesn't really have hair, so it's hard to tell. I wonder if I could just give him short hair too. Maybe some like wild hair. I was liking wild. Maybe something like that. That's kind of wild. Hey, it's a little too styled. Maybe something like this. Kind of like that. And it's messy, you know? That's the vibe I was going for. Now let's go to outfits. Here are his outfits. We have his everyday look, formal look, sleepwear, his party outfit, swimwear, hot weather, and cold weather. So while we're in Cass, I just want to take a look at our children real quick. I want to check out these new traits that I downloaded. So I have Damia as gloomy right now and Tiro as hothead. Looks like most of them or all of them are under the lifestyle traits. And I'm liking this one. Sensitive. To manage their need for alone time, these children can hang out under the covers in a bed, make up stories in their head, and use leave me alone when away from home in need of a quiet zone. So I kind of want to give her the sensitive trait. Yeah, I think Dami is a little sensitive. And for right now, with Hothead, I was kind of eyeing bold as natural leaders. These children can incite domestic defiance, organize the quiet game, practice looking competent in the mirror, and are prone to mischief. And also the rocket, the energy of these children seems to have no end. They love to run around, get hyped, fight themselves, and carry around a secret sugar stash. But at the same time, I'm still kind of getting hot-headed vibes from this kid. So I think we'll probably incorporate some new traits with little baby Nias. But for right now, we'll just use the CC trait on Damia. But thank you once again for What's It Toya for the suggestion. I hope I'm saying your name right. I love this. It added a lot more to the game, just like you thought it would. Sweet. So I'm actually going to get rid of this bed here and the baby crib, just because our household is full right now. We don't have the money and we don't have the household space for that. Oh my goodness, such a cutie. Good night, Nias. Good night. Oh. What's this? Whoa, I forgot I was in tab mode. What is over here? A lump of clay. I love how it looks though. I love what Nulo created here. That's really cool. It's another day, another hunt. And we have Tato meditating. I also switched her hot weather and athletic outfits so it wouldn't be so big time nasty. Today's hunt's gonna be a little different because Nulo is coming along. What is this music? What? Is that what happens when they become scared? Whoa, that music scared me. Jeez. They're gonna head here together. This time they're bringing Nulo along because they want to look for some plants as well. Etta's busy with her new baby and Tato has to meditate. So today they are gonna follow the river. They're also still looking for a way out of here, especially now that Kha found them. They don't really want to be found like that again. So they're gonna follow the river and we'll see what they can find. These guys followed the whole river all the way down to here. I brought these guys here because I realized we're really struggling with the gardening skill and getting collectibles. Hold on, kitty's at the door.
Hi. Come in. Good morning. Make up your mind.
Oh my gosh. He was just standing in the doorway and he couldn't decide if he wanted to come in or out. So he was mostly out. So he stayed out. That was a stupid story. So anyway, we're struggling a lot on collectibles and gardening just because it is winter. And I set winter to be longer because I want it to be the ice age. So we have to complete one in-game collection. So we also just collected the rainbow firefly. But if I go here, we can see we must complete the fishing, gardening, metal frog, or fossil collection. But I was looking through all of the different eras and you never have one instance where you have to complete the insect collection. So I'm thinking that might be something that we could do just because I think fossils are hard to find in Granite Falls and fishing and gardening are on hold because of the extended winter. So anyway, we have one. Actually, let's look. I think we have more than one insect in our household collection. We have one frog, 9 fish out of 22, I mean, we might be able to get the fish. I'm not sure. Just not all the expansion fish. Okay, I thought we caught dragonflies, right? Maybe they don't count. But anyway, yeah, we got some insects. Wow. Nulo, that is a mood. I might have to do a little bit of bird's eye view. Here we have this collectible. What I really want to do in this area though is I know there is like a little garden right in the middle of Granite Falls, and I don't know why I just randomly started talking faster. I don't know. But I read that there are potatoes there, and that is like the one winter plant that we have access to. Here's some more insects in another digging spot. I know this is kind of immersion breaking here, but let's see. We can't do anything to the onion, which is also, I guess, a winter plant. And here's the potato plant, which is not grown. How long have we been in winter? Oh my gosh. Anyway, we've got some insects. We had just caught mosquitoes. 3 mosquitoes. Thank you, Teb. And Zol dug up a couple time capsules. That makes sense. Yeah, I remember doing this more in the beginning of my series and I stopped. Oh my gosh, we got Jenny. Okay. So I also noticed along the river, there is this elk that I don't remember placing these animals, guys. I did it right when I first set up the whole world before episode 1, but it's conveniently right by the river. So we can totally go to our spinner. Let's give it a go. Don't forget, Tato's meditating good fortune. Please. I get this too much now. I do too much. Oh, God. I'm just cackling because, of course, the first hunt of the day, someone would get injured. Okay, great progress was made. So who's gonna get injured, though? decisions. Nulo wasn't even there. Zol was here. Teb was the closest. You know what? Hold up. I was gonna do a spinner to see which 3, but it wouldn't make sense for Nulo. We could flip a coin though. Let's say Teb is heads and Zol is tails. Hey Google, flip a coin.
You got heads.
It landed on heads. Teb is unfortunately injured. So I'm gonna send him home with Nulo so she can help him walk and stuff. Let me bring her here. Zol's gonna keep it going. Teb kind of had to hunt on his own last episode. Now it's Zol's turn. Oh, I'm sorry, Teb. Now it's up to Zol, buddy. But it also means we have to get rid of this. Zol also found some frogs, or a place to find frogs, by the lake. What a view. A little birdie. And we caught a surfer leaf frog. Very cool. Now there's also another elk, which Zol can attempt to take down on his own. I don't know how well it's gonna go. And I believe there was another dig site that I found somewhere over here. All right, let's see. Come on, Tato, please. Please. All right, I'll take it. We got some fur. Okay, let's get that fur, baby. All right, so we'll keep looking for collectibles, but that's good to know that we got fur. We have another dig site right here. Limestone, perfect, right on point. You know what, guys, I'm seeing another animal. I don't know, let's just keep going for it. All right, poor guy. So uncomfortable. Oh, and while we were on our little walk, Tato reached wellness level 6. Tato can now give sports massages and suggest visualization techniques. She can now perform the Lord of the Dance pose in yoga. Ooh, I'm gonna have to see what that looks like. So this guy's pretty big. Let's check it out. I swear, if we get another injury. Tato, wellness 6. Wellness level 6. You got this. Okay. More fur. We found some ladybugs, and we also found another dig spot. Row. Yeah. Could even be the same one, but we can dig it up again for some reason. We'll try it. What could be inside? An alabaster. Okay, let's sell all of these, and we can open the limestone. Woohoo! We got a sea monster. But I think that's all we can really explore over here. So I was having Zol get some rest Oh, it went away. But I was having him do that before we looked for more collectibles. And while we were doing that, I got this notification. While meditating, Tato of the Tari had an insight on how to make plants grow big and tall. She gained some gardening skill. That's really cool. I wonder how much she gained. I don't know what it was at before, but she's almost at level 3. Well, it's kind of sad. And she wants to help Teb with his injury, but she's also trying to help Zol out, and she doesn't feel like she has that energy anymore. She wants to reconnect with this woman. Teb is just trying to sleep off the pain. Let's get Zol up. I'll focus on healing Teb in a sec. I'm just looking for some collectibles, and I actually see some fireflies. I'm gonna go collect those. All right, there we go.
Excellent.
Aha! Fireflies. I have Nulo coming to start working on the garden. I also noticed we can evolve a couple of plants. We have nice quality lemon trees now. I wonder if I can evolve any of these. Doesn't look like it. That's okay, we can still harvest them and then sell them. I will keep Zol on the move. So Zol found quite a few things. First, he found this rock right by the waterfall. We're gonna open that up. Oh, a time capsule. All right, next we're gonna go get some wild sage. Then we found an elk, another one. Oh no, Zol. Don't run inside though, you gotta keep going. We found another rock we can dig up and some dragonflies. This heavy snow has become a blizzard, so I'm really hoping things will go well for him. Oh no, poor guy. Oh, he's back. He got the sage, now he's moving on to go find that animal. Oh, Zol.
Yeah.
This era is really torture, huh?
Ooh.
All right, here it is. We're approaching it. Oh, look at that. I'm going to try to come back to that. You can do it, Zol. You can do it. Let's find out if all of that was worth it. Let's see. God, that was lucky. Jeez. I really expected it to land on injured right there. Woo! Oh no, is he gonna pass out? Wait, I had one more dig site. It was hard to find too, dude. Last but not least, we're gonna look for some frogs. And I really don't want to torture Zol more than I need to since we already got some food. But Zol's gonna put a marker on where this elk or this deer is so they can get that hiding spot so they'll they'll know for next time. Dude, he's too uncomfortable. So he's gonna just do a quick little sleep in the blizzard till he's comfortable enough to get the frogs. So now Zol is just uncomfortable, not very uncomfortable, so he can look for frogs. Frogs. Why'd I say it like that?
Plus it's a boo.
Another surfer leaf frog. Then it's just bed for everyone. Tato's feeling the best out of all of them. All of the adults anyway. So I'm gonna have her cook the feast. We'll just do Kalua pork once again. Ooh, level 3! Level 3 of cooking. I also saw some insects over here, but they might have flown away. These ones look new too. They're like little butterflies. Fun fact, I'm actually scared of butterflies. It's a very weird fear. I don't know why I have it, but
I do.
They seem to have flown off, but we can harvest our wild sage bush. Check this out. Teb actually got an injury from the campfire, so that kind of works. I don't have to cheat his injury. I'm gonna get rid of this one then, because I just cheated the injury. What are you doing? I love how they just collapse on the ground. Making snow angels. So as you can see, he doesn't have that much of a serious injury. That's why Tata's kind of taking her time with this. We're gonna eat our meal and then do a quick club gathering. Actually, before we do the meal, I have some new CC to share. I'm hoping it works. There is this really cool toddler high chair. A stone high chair. Maybe this color. I'll move one of these to the inventory and put the high chair here for now. I don't know if it's gonna work. We'll have to try. And we have a new fossil. This is the fossil sea monster. Interesting. So I'm thinking to switch it up. We get rid of one of the raptor claws and put this one on the shelf. there we go. We have two different fossils. Can sell their seed, sell our insects. Let's open this up. We got DJ Candy, and we made a bunny sculpture for like the fifth time, so we can sell that. Whoa, this is like a new buff. Irrational danger from being screamed at. Zol is scared. Why? Who knows? Who screamed at him? The meal's ready. Tato's getting it for everybody. Let's snatch that up. Eta's attempting to put Nias to bed. He's angry about it. Well, no, he's angry because his needs are abysmal. And she reached parenting level 4. Tato, come a little closer. And place in world. Yay! Now call to meal. Yay! Come get your food! Get your food, everybody! Come get your food! Kind of wanted you guys sitting around the fire, not gonna lie. Alright, Eta, thank you for being the best. Why? Why are Sims like this? And why did Eta get up and move? Once this meal is over, I'm gonna start a club gathering. There's two meals left. But I was taking a look at our club. I'm thinking, let's see if we have points. We could add another person and then add the kiddos. Wait, actually, let me open it in Tato's because she has permission to add people. We can upgrade to 7. So I'm going to do that. Now we can add the kids. We'll add Tiro and Dania. Beautiful. Now I want to get rid of Be Friendly with the Bata just because we're not really seeing them right now. And I'm going to add Look for Frogs. And I'm going to put Go Hiking for now. Go Hiking will help us to find animals. So now that everyone's added, let's start a gathering and just see what they get up to. But I'm not letting them sleep. Stop sleeping. You can sleep later. It's 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Oh, wait. I'm getting Nias and Tiro confused. Nias, you can still sleep. Don't worry. I have the mod that lets children garden, so we can take a look at that, but I do think that Nulo already did all the gardening. Oh no! Okay, Damia can sell the sage. Eta's already over here selling the plants too. Or she might be harvesting. Yep, she's harvesting the plants. Nulo already harvested 95, so we can sell all these, get some money. For some reason, we have a cardboard dance floor. I'll sell it. I don't know how it got here. And rainbow butterfly. Boom. And Nulo reached handiness level 3. She's making something. We can light a fire outside. Nulo made a horse sculpture. I think that's new too, so I want to keep that. Oh, look, actually another horse sculpture. So one is 20, one is 40. So I'll sell the $40 one. We need to mount some fish. I'll mount this one and pop that right there. Yay! Zol really wants to sleep. Oh my gosh, he loves bunnies. He made another bunny sculpture. Let's try large lumberjack. I just want to check on their skills. Kindness is level 6. Teb, his fitness is level 6. I'm letting him work on his fitness since he can't fish. He can go boxing because he's an active sim, so he would enjoy that. Tato identified some fish. She's gonna chat with Zol. Nulo's gonna do some woodwork. Eta's woodworking. No one's looking for frogs. Since Nulo's just standing there, I'm gonna have Nulo go on a little search. Nulo found some rocks she's digging up. She went deep into the forest and she's kind of eyeing this mysterious thing right here, but it's kind of creeping her out a bit, so she's gonna leave it alone for now. So I found some frogs in the world. They're right here, but I'm so shocked when I look over here. Oh, a leopard frog. When I look over here, there's a gravestone and it's Kha. And I mean, this was so, I didn't even know it happened. I know I do storytelling, but this was not my doing. That is crazy. If you saw in the beginning, the Kawa took Kha in. They brought him back to their place and now he's dead. So, I mean, you can easily put 2 and 2 together, right? I bet he's dead because they killed him. And I was trying to incorporate somehow ending this episode with the Tari encountering the Kawa. This seems like a perfect opportunity that The Sims just kind of worked its way out for me. I can't believe it. Let's collect these insects. Ew. We got some stink bugs. Nice. I wonder if we can put it in our inventory. And then we can question the Kawa with that. Yeah, unaffected by his death though, I guess. No one's sad about it. But I guess we left things off on a really bad note. Wow, I had so much planned for Ka. I'm shocked. So we're just gonna collect these last couple of things, and then I think we'll end the club gathering. In the next episode, I want to focus on the encounter between the two groups or the two tribes, just because I think that deserves a little more time and focus into. We got some limestone, and we also got treasure too. We got a box. Last one I could find, right by our garden. That's not a garden. What is it? A treasure map. Okay. Let's sell our insects and our frog. We can open up our box and extract our fossil. We got Goth Boy and fossilized plant imprint and a broken fossil. I can sell the broken fossil. It seems like we're gonna have to put another shelf in. Oh, that one's really pretty. So we can put all our fossils together. I like that a lot. But for now, it'll be here. Aito's almost ready to level up her painting skill. I'm thinking either before or when this painting is finished. And then she will be level 6. We're getting most of our skills to level 6. And then I want to pop the easel in the inventory and do our first ever painting from reference. Ah, she didn't reach it. She's so close. I bet she will when she does these paintings from reference, unless it's just stuck there. Let's get a group of everyone. Everyone. You know what? Nias looks a lot like Kaios, which is actually his half-brother. So I had everyone come here for a group photo, and there's a rainbow. What's more perfect than that? Etha's still on her way. She had this weird game going on of picking up and putting down Nias like 20 times, so... Wow, this is gorgeous. We got our easel. Well, I spent so long trying to get this right with the angle of the easel and all the people posing in the right spot that the rainbow's gone and our bills came. We have $2,000 and we owe... Oh, $2,954. So you need another $900. Oh, don't go home. Don't go home. But anyway, let's paint. We'll do a large painting. Oh, the rainbow's back. Yay. Okay. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Yes. This is what I want. This is what I want. I wish I could rotate it. Awesome. I guess I'll just have to stand like that till it's painted. I know they don't really have to in The Sims, but makes it realistic, although it's really creeping me out. So we'll just watch Etta. Oh, this is looking so good! I wonder if the waterfall will come up in her picture. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Woo! Wow! She did it! Oh my gosh. It's not the best of quality. Maybe we'll try again someday, but for right now, I love it! And yes, she reached painting level 6, and Tyrell reached social level 2. We do not want to sell this to collector. We want to frame it.
Oh, no, 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 no.
That's too modern. I think I can remove the frame. Now we'll have everyone else come pose. I want to do this group because it's like the original Tari. It started with these four guys, then Etta joined. Then I want to have the kids pose. We have this super cute setup right by the monkey bars, and hopefully it'll come out. I want it looking toward the viewer. All right, let's try again. A large painting from reference. Please work. Please and thank you. Yay! So cute! Although the toddler pose, I don't know, the mouth kind of creepy, and you can't even see their playground, but that's okay. Why won't you center? There, I think that's cute. Let's see it be born. This is the next gen, you guys. And there might be more to come. Oh, look, we can come dig that up too. Look at that coming together. That's what I'm talking about. What is that? I'm sorry, hold on. wait. But what is this though? Oh man, it's a bear doing a snow angel. It looked like some kind of animal weaseling its way into the ground. There we go. Nulo dug up the time capsule. Tata's selling sage. And she reached level 3 of gardening. Let's see what's in our capsule. More cubeless. And we had old Gabby too. Did any of you guys ever play My Sims? That used to be my jam back in the day. I'm liking this one even more than the adults. I mean, how could you not? It's so cute. These bears, man, freaking me out. Look how nice. Oh my gosh, in one stroke, it's finished. Look at that beauty. Okay, put that in your inventory. And then you can put this in your inventory too, because we're all done with it. Whoa, let me just find a spot for them. Maybe it's this room. This room's kind of empty. There's the Tari group, and these are the kiddos. I removed the frame. Maybe like that, and then we'll leave room for one more. For now, though, I could put something in between. Put a little fish in between. It's bugging me that it's not centered. That looks a little more centered. What do you think? Very nice. I'm gonna end the gathering once I sell this. Ends the gathering. Tato's not doing so well either. She was injured as well. As you can see, Tato's been trying to heal Teb and there's no luck. He's still injured. And so she's feeling stuck. She's worried about what to do next. But she knows one thing. She can meditate. We'll watch her go do that. And we'll find out what she learns. Anyway, guys, thanks for sticking around watching episode 9 of Journey Through Time. If you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to hit that like button, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.